So a couple of days ago, I finished study for microbiology for step one, and then I decided to finish all the questions of microbiology in New World. And luckily, I've got a score ranging from 80 to 90% per block. So in this video, I'll show you how I prepared for microbiology and what benefited me the most. For sources, I exclusively focused on first aid for microbiology. And a lot of people complain about microbiology in first aid because it doesn't have any explanations. It's just basically plain facts. But microbiology in general doesn't have anything to explain in the first place. It's just facts about microbes that you need to organize and memorize in your head. And my only source for microbiology was first aid. Secondly, you need to cover everything in first aid for microbiology. It's about 80 pages, which is very long for first aid. But it's very important to go through all of it before you actually start studying for microbiology. And by going through it, I don't mean that you should stick in each page for 30 minutes. And I also don't mean that you should skim through the whole thing. But you'll need to read all the text and all the topics and see all the pictures. It should take you about 5 minutes per page. After you've read the entire microbiology section in first aid, now it's time to actually study microbiology. So you're going to go back to the first page and start memorizing and organizing the topics one by one in your head. And as you're studying, make sure that you focus on the unique features of the diseases and the organisms. And I can tell you that every disease and every organism in microbiology have that one unique feature that differentiates it from others. And it's very crucial to know that one unique detail or that one unique word linked to this disease, because as you're reading the question and you see that word is going to light up in your head and you're going to know that this is talking about this disease or talking about the other bacteria or whatever. But somebody would ask, how would I know if this feature is unique or not? And that's the benefit of reading everything in the first place from A to Z, because when you've read everything before, you've seen multiple symptoms or multiple features that keep occurring over and over again in multiple diseases, but there's always that one feature that stands out. Virulence factors are very, very important. You'd really be surprised about the number of questions written about the bacterial virulence factors. And sadly, the majority of these questions have low answer rate. I've made a video before about the bacterial virulence factors in this channel. When you're going through first aid, you're going to find some virulence factors in this bacteria and some others in other pages and some others ahead, very far ahead. So in this video, I've collected everything in just one place. So I highly recommend watching it after you finish this video. I'm going to put the card at the end. You'll also need to know the general features of bacteria and viruses. So you'll have to get yourself familiar with these terms, transformation, conjugation, transportation, and transduction for bacteria. And for viruses, you need to know these terms, recombination, reassortment, complementation, and phenotypic mixing. You'll have to truly understand what we mean by each one of these terms. If you guys find these features difficult to understand or to differentiate between them, make sure you tell me down in the comment section below, and if enough of you want a video about them, I will make a video explaining them. Stains and agars are also messy because they're all over first aid, and you need to know all stains and all agars for all bacteria. I know it's very long, it's very tedious, but it's very, very important. Also, you need to know the special tests that are mentioned in first aid. What I did is I've got a piece of paper and I've written down all the tests that I've come across. There's about 10 or 15 special tests that you'll need to know. The transmission of diseases is very, very, very important. I guarantee that you will be asked about the transmission of diseases either directly or indirectly, so you'll need to know how each and every disease transmits. The ridiculous part about it is that a lot of diseases share a common vector or a common way of transmission. So what I did is that I've got a piece of paper and I've written down all the transmissions for all organisms all at once. So I have them all in one paper and I can just revise them very easily. Then there comes the question about fungi, protozoa, and worms. Do you study them or not? Are they important? Fortunately, I've seen very few questions about fungi, protozoa, and worms, but fungi seems to have the upper hand. So I wouldn't really recommend focusing on them and studying them first, but just leave them till the end, till the very end when you've finished everything. So don't ignore them, just keep them last. And finally, this is very, very important, you'll need to know the treatment of all organisms and all diseases. For some reason, they focus so much on the treatment for organisms and diseases. Honestly, the majority of the questions just ask about the name of the drug that would treat this disease without going into further details about the mechanism of action or the side effects. So again, like fungi, protozoa, and worms, I would recommend you that you know all the treatment first, and then at the very end, you go back to study the side effects and whatnot. But you'll have to know how we treat each and every disease. Alright guys, these are the steps that I followed. Hopefully they're gonna help you. It took me a while to finish microbiology, but finally it is done. So now I can move on to another subject, and hopefully I made this easier for you. And if you have any questions whatsoever, feel more than free to ask me in the comment section below. And see you guys later.